another Elementor tutorial. Today we'll be talking about the divider widget. Let's start right now. So drag and drop the divider widget to your website over here. The first thing you'll notice is that the divider has a lot of styles. Elementor has the most styles I've ever seen within a page builder. So well done, Elementor. Now, if you want to see what's going on, we have to change the color of it and we have to make it a little bit bigger. Where you do that? Well, let's go to style and you can change the color. Let's make it white so we all can see what's happening. And we're also going to change the weight to make it a little bit more bigger so you actually see what's happening on this video. We'll change it back later on in the video. Right, let's get back to content. So the styles, yes, we have a lot of styles. You can make it curved, rhombus, parallels, dots, even trees, leaves, why not? Half rounds, tribal, axes, a zigzag, squares, rectangles, arrows, of course, dotted, curved, curly, squared, zigzags, multiple, trees and stripes. You get the point, I think. We're going to use the double line and we're going to create something beautiful with it. All right, next up is the width. With the width, you can actually make it a little bit smaller. In our case, that would be useful because 100% width, it just slides through the entire image and we don't want it. But what we want is, I want it to stop at the T of great. So let's make the width 42%, which is great. Then we have the alignment. You can align it on the left side, that's default, or we can align it in the center or on the right. Well, we're not gonna align it anywhere, so it's default on the left. And this is the cool part, you can add an element. With text, you can just add text within your divider. Divider text, which is really great, and you can actually give it a H1 or H2. And when you select the text, when we go to style, you have a new tab called text. And here you can style the entire text to make it, for example, white. And change the typography to make it something beautiful like this. It is all possible within the text option. And of course the position, if you want to be centered or on the right. Center is the most beautiful in my case. Here we have the spacing, so you can change the spacing of the text within the divider. All right, that's all about the text. Let's go back to content. You can also choose an icon. If you click on it, you can of course upload your own SVG, or you can go to the icon library. And within this icon library, of course, you can choose all the icons within Elementor, and those are a lot. So let's say I want, for this example, I want to have a weight, or I want to have a dumbbell, because a dumbbell really fits our website. Press insert. Now we have it over here. You can't change anything further on this tab, but let's go to style. And now we can see instead of text, there is an icon. And within the icon, you can change the view to make it stacked or framed. It's just a view of the icon. You can of course change the size. Oh, let's first change the color so we can actually see better what we are doing. Color over here, you can use a global color. If you don't know what global colors are, go back to my first widget, which is the heading widget, which I fully explain about global colors and global fonts. We're gonna pick white. You can change the size of your icon and you can change again the position. You want it on the left side, the center, or on the right side. Let's keep it on the center. The spacing, well, we now definitely need more space because of the size of the icon. So let's give it some space of 40. And then you can also rotate it if you want the icon to be rotated, which gives you a really great effect if you want to just spin this thing around. If you change the icon to, for example, stacked, we get a little bit of more options, which is the secondary color. This is the secondary color. So the secondary color is now actually the icon color. And you also get a new option, which is border radius. If you use this, then you can get a fully round icon like this, which really looks great because of the roundings within the dumbbell. And if I now change it to framed, the icon color changes. Now it's the secondary color, is the background color of the icon. So I can make it, for example, red, like this. And now we can also change the border width to make it more bigger. And then the border radius, of course, you can change it back to make it square again. I really like the stacked feature, but default is also really great. That is the icon and the text. Now, if you go back to divider, you can actually change the color of your lines or your solid or your zigzag or whatever to make it whatever you want. So if you want to make it red, let's keep it on white, this thing. You can change the weight of it. We already demonstrated. It just gets bigger. Now, don't think that 0 and 10 is the only option you have. You can also go make it 100, like this. Or you can make it 50, like this. And then the gap creates more space between different widgets within the container, like this. Let's change the weight back to 25. I think this weight was great, but now the icon is way too big. So you go back to icon. We can change the size, make it smaller. And then I don't like the border width, which is really too big. It should be like this. Now the icon is a bit too small, so we're going to like this. And also the frame should be black. Yes, this is great. You can also make it transparent. Just use the clear option or just slide it to transparent. Whenever you want, both works. And this looks pretty great. All right, last step is the advanced tab. Well, within the advanced tab, everything is exactly the same as I told you in the first widget about the header. A few things are an exception. If you want to change the width, then you can't change it here to full width. No, you have to go back to content and change the width over here. If you also want to use the align self method, don't use it because your lines will disappear. So don't use this one. Go back to content and I'll use the alignment of this widget. And all the rest of the advanced options are absolutely exactly the same as with the header widget. And while we're at it, let's also talk about the spacer, because it's just such a small widget. If you just drag and drop it over here, the only option you can actually do is change the space. That's basically what the spacer does. It's very useful if you don't want to change the margins of other widgets. So this way you can actually create some space. You can change between view height and EM, which you can use to create more spacing like this. So at the advanced options, you can change a lot of things about the spacer, but of course nothing will really happen with your spacer because you won't see it on the front end, but you can add a background. If you, for example, want to have a color, you can create a color with your spacer like this. Or you can use an image, for example, like the trees we've used, these ones. And then you can change, of course, the position to let it actually seen. And now when you have your website, you will actually see a spacer with the image. I would definitely not know why you want this, because when you're adding an image, just use the image widget. I hope you learned something new about the divider widget. If you did, hit that like button so I know I was on the right track. If you have questions or you just want to say thank you, Doug, drop them down in the comments and I always reply because I love you guys. If you want to see more widgets explained and demonstrated, follow the playlist or click on the next video. Subscribe if you want to see more videos about WordPress and, well, you know how it goes. Have an awesome day and I'll see you in the next video.